Hello, this is Thae Yong Ho. North Korea's Ri Son Kwon's remarks that whether the cold noodles made their way down their throats to South Korea's top business executives has become a major controversy. There are some who claim that a formal apology should be received as it was not an one-off rude behavior, while others say that we should look at the background of that remark and there is no need to overreact to the North Koreans' culture of direct jokes. To be honest, when I first heard about the cold noodle remarks, I was suspicious of that incident, and if it were to be true, I thought it wasn't right to let it slip by. Regardless of the background of that remark before and after, if Ri Son Kwon had said such a thing in front of the South Korean conglomerates, it is still regarded nonetheless as a great insulting. In North Korea, however, the statement like, "Is the food going down your throat?" is often said by parents to their children as well as those superiors to inferiors. Usually, North Korean people do not feel to be insulted or uncomfortable from hearing these words. Furthermore, considering the fact that Ri Son Kwon had come to eat noodles with South Korean conglomerates, I don't think he had said it with an intention to provoke anybody. Even until the early 2000s, when I worked at the North Korean Ministry of Foreign Affairs, American side was written Yankees or American bastards, while we used those chinks and those ruskies when referring to China and Russia in all documents given to Kim Jong-il. This was the normal way to show loyalty to the party as well as independence in politics. But one day, Kim Jong-il warned then First Deputy Foreign Minister Kang Suk-joo that while these words were popular in the public, if diplomats as well would often use such vulgar expressions, then they would easily make unnecessary mistakes while conducting diplomatic activities. As a result, expressions such as those Yankees, chinks, and those Ruskies were banned in all documents in foreign ministry. As North Korean party and state officials are often told by the party to be careful in their languages in front of public, it is possible that Ri Son Kwon had said the noodle remark to lighten the mood. In this way, I think it would be too extreme to demand a formal apology from North Korea and even demand the dismiss from the current position. If we are to demand formal apologies from North Korea, we should start with the issues such as only flying North Korean flag at welcome ceremony at the airport when President Moon Jae-in arrived in Pyongyang, or the fact that symbol of North Korean Workers' Party was placed on top of the Korean Peninsula at the backdrop of the photograph commemorating the Pyongyang Inter-Korean Summit. Only flying the North Korean flag at the reception ceremony for President Moon and choosing a political venue that signifies the North Korean Workers' Party's unifying Korea under the banner of Juche ideology by force as a place for a commemoration photograph is a major violation of the basic agreement reached in 1991 that relation between North and South Korea is a special one leading towards unification. Reunification of the Korean Peninsula begins with the change of the North Koreans' perceptions, and in order to that, we must begin with enlightening them of their mistakes. By all means, Kim Jong-un is aware of the controversy surrounding Ri Son Kwon's noodle remark. It was probably also a shock for Ri Son Kwon himself, and I'm sure he will be careful at any future inter-Korean events. I believe that it is reasonable from the perspective of rapprochement between North and South Korea that Ri Son Kwon's noodle controversy should end here, and we should take one step further towards denuclearization and a peaceful unification of the Korean Peninsula. Thank you.